Today we're looking at different types of Marvel puzzles that you can solve in Marvel's Avengers, and this is how you solve them to get to that special loot, that really good loot behind those closed doors. So the first type of door or puzzle that you have to open is really simple. You just have to stand on it. Like, it's just a standing platform. Once you're standing on it, it's like a pressure plate. You know, you just stand on it, the pressure plate goes down, the door opens. Sometimes there are four of them. I found one where I was playing with my AI, and I was like, please stand on the freaking pressure plates, AI. And they're like, no, fam, we stand with you. We stand together. And I'm like, please just go. I want to open the door, man. I want to open the door. I want the loot. But yeah, in essence, some of them you can actually stand alone. You just stand on the pressure plate. Once you stand on there, the kind of lights will go green around the door and on the floor, I think. And then the door will open. Quite simple. The other one is quite a basic one, which you'll see inside most of the interior buildings, is where you basically need Hulk or someone who can smash, or like Iron Man with Hulkbuster because he can't use his actual attacks, to break one of those doors. They actually teach you how to do this as Hulk in the tutorial of like the kind of intro of the game. So that was also one of the ways to kind of go through those doors. I think Black Widow is also unable to actually get through that door. I think she might have to use her ultimate heroic ability to get through there. And then there's a really confusing one that blends into the scenery, dude. Like, this one baffled me because I encountered it a few times where there can be like multiple ones of them. Usually it's like four of them, right? And they spread into different sections of this like indoor kind of place. And it's kind of like got this weird like mosaic hexagon thing, and you have to punch it until it goes all the way back, and then it activates, it goes green, and you have to go find all the other ones and punch those in at the same time so that you're able to unlock the door. And it does have a time limit. If you kind of don't find the next one in time, the first one's going to pop out again, and you're going to have to like do all of them in a quick time sequence once you start. And the final type of puzzle door that you have to open is really hard to see. Like, at first I signed it up to like, yeah, you can't open these doors like in the beta, man. This is like, they're like, when the main game comes out, in these missions, you'll be able to unlock these doors. It took me like 10 hours to realize that. Wait a minute, what are these circle things on these weird pillars like all around the freaking place? Oh, well, it turns out if you throw things or shoot at it, it basically makes the green sound, and you're like, oh my god, it's one of the switches. And you can find up to four of them all around the kind of building or the door that you're trying to access for that extra loot, dude. And you just gotta, activate all of them, find them in the quick time sequence that you have. It's not really actually that quick. Like, you really don't have to speed run it. You just have to, like, know where they are. Like, okay, cool, that one, run around the building. Oh, that one. And then the door will be like, zoo, open sesame, here's your loot, dude. Thanks for playing, high five, and come again. Like, you know, and obviously the puzzles change in all the missions constantly. So every time you replay a mission, these puzzles and the map layout seems to change ever so slightly. I feel like it keeps changing because I keep like experiencing that. It's kind of weird. And that's how you kind of open all the puzzles, and that's what you should get used to for when you get the game. I hope this kind of helps you and gives you that insight into how to open these puzzles so you don't spend 10 hours losing out on all this extra loot because you didn't know how to shoot the damn thing at the top. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one.